Well, it's been a day of celebration across the country as families marked Easter Sunday with egg hunts, church services and special deliveries. Reid Butler reports.
Well, it is a special day for so many, especially for the kids here at Luna Park, where an Easter egg hunt is underway, and it is chaotic. It was every girl and boy for themselves as they searched high and low, trying to get as many of the chocolate eggs as possible.
You, like, find them, but then some of them are squashed. Like, probably 25.
It was a similar story in homes right across the country this morning. Chocolate for breakfast, totally allowed today.
Happy Easter!
Happy Easter!
At the Monash Children's Hospital in Melbourne, there was a special visitor on the ward.
Whoa!
Little James couldn't get enough, going in for hug after hug.
He's had a pretty hard time the last couple of weeks, so he's been very unhappy, and if you ask the nurses, it's actually really good to see him so happy and smiling.
Elsewhere, Christians celebrated Easter morning at special church services.
I think that message of forgiveness and salvation and family looking after one another is super important.
The whole atmospheric experience of new life and hope, I think, is very powerful.
With the day drawing to a close now, many are no doubt relaxing with their families, a lot more relaxing than this, I would imagine. Hopefully, nursing a full belly.
Prime Minister Anthony Albanese has used his Easter message shared on social media to remind the country of the importance of forgiveness and grace.
Happy Easter, Australia. Easter is a time of hope and renewal. For Christians here and across the world, it's a moment to reflect on the resurrection.
The PM also paid tribute to Australians working or going through a difficult time this long weekend. Two people have been rescued after spending 10 hours trapped in a cave near the Blue Mountains. They'd been part of a group exploring the area when the alarm was raised last night. Jack Hahn with the story.
It was a 12-hour ordeal for this man and woman stuck deep inside the Jenolan Caves, more than 100 kilometres west of Sydney. Emergency services got the call just after 7 o'clock to head to the remote and rugged location. It was a huge response from the emergency services, from police rescue units to the SES and multiple ambulance crews, including intensive care paramedics. For close to 9 hours, they drilled into the rocks to carve out a path for the pair to be walked out safely, and just before 5 o'clock they were taken out of the caves.
The extrication itself was extremely difficult. Had to access the patient and implement some drilling into the surrounding rock to assist with the extrication of the patient. This obviously was a delicate operation and took quite some time.
It's understood the pair were visiting the Blue Mountains from Canberra. They have been cleared of any injuries and will be able to return home this afternoon.
A church has gone up in flames in Adelaide's southern suburbs, devastating its community at one of the holiest times of the year. The blaze at the Greek Orthodox Church has been deemed accidental, but what sparked it is unknown. Beth Excel has more.
The damage from the blaze is so extensive, parishioners who arrived here for Sunday service this morning weren't allowed to go inside.
It went up less than an hour after Saturday Mass had ended. Within minutes, flames engulfed the entrance, quickly spreading at the Greek Orthodox parish of St Andrew in Adelaide South.
The plume of smoke was coming up right over the roof.
But come daylight, even fire wasn't enough to stop Sunday service from going ahead.
It's very emotional. It's their church. The parishioners here are for more than 40 years or so. It's like their home.
There's no way that the service isn't going to go ahead. That's just not an option for Orthodox Christians.
It's just another way to show faith.
The fire station just metres up the road meant crews were on scene within minutes, quickly stopping the spread. Now the task to identify exactly what's been lost.
Maybe this is a spiritual meaning for hope and for everyone. It's the same thing. We have a hole on the roof now, so we can ask for mercy.
This is one of the busiest times of the year in the lead up to Greek Orthodox Easter, which is just a few weeks away. Some parishioners will attend services twice a day. Planning is now underway for how and where they'll be held.
And investigators suspect a massage parlour in Brisbane was deliberately set alight. As Jacob Chico reports, the fire was one of two in a busy night for emergency services.
Fire investigators have started their morning here at this Norman Park massage parlour after it went up in flames around 2 o'clock. Firefighters raced to the scene as soon as the blaze took hold, and police say it wasn't occupied at the time. Thankfully, it appears damage to neighbouring businesses and homes is minimal. Investigators will now try to determine today whether the business was deliberately lit.
Very relieved, yeah. It's like a heritage listed building, so it would have gone up very quickly. So nothing has invaded our business at all, which is great. I had a client in today, so we just had to do it without power.
Around the same time, crews were responding to this house fire at Tingalpa. Neighbours were woken by loud noises and then fierce flames, so they immediately called 000. There's significant damage to the home. It's understood the owners are currently overseas. What sparked this blaze isn't clear. Fire investigators will return here soon. Anyone with information on both of these fires is being urged to contact police.
Advocacy groups are calling for low-interest loans to help more Australians switch to solar. New polling shows the majority of people opposing electrification are doing so because of the cost. Political editor Charles Croucher.
Electricity bills have long had the unavoidable feel of death and taxes, but tonight solar advocacy groups say the improved combination of rooftop solar, batteries and electric vehicles mean higher power bills are no longer inevitable, and Australians are open to the idea. Exclusive polling from Redbridge shows 38% support of electrification compared to 33% against. But when offered low-interest loans to remove the heavy upfront costs, the number in favour grows to 52% and opposition halves to 16%. Rewiring Australia are now using these numbers to call for a HECS-style scheme for households.
We really think this is the circuit breaker Australia needs in the energy wars. In the future, the Australian grid will be much cheaper for consumers because they will be producing much more of their energy themselves with rooftop solar and then storing it in batteries.
Years ago, if you wanted to reduce your carbon footprint, it was going to cost you. But now you actually do that and you're saving a whole lot of money.
That's Peter Orberg. He's a retiree who says he's saved $4,000 a year through electrification. We'll have more on how at 6:00.